Okay, now let's go through an example of how to calculate real GDP. So let's take a country for our example. And to make this simple, easily understandable, we'll say they only make one thing in the economy. So we'll have a country that only makes pizzas. Delicious pizzas. And we're going to go back a few years to 2012 for a particular reason. Well, I'll show you later. But let's say in 2012, they made 1,000 pizzas. And in the next year, they made 1,500 pizzas. And the year after that, 1,500 to 1,350. So there's some downturn in the economy. But then the next year, 2,000 pizzas. So the economy picked up again. Now let's say that the price of pizzas in 2012 was $9. But there was some inflation, and the next year, pizzas went up, $10 now. And inflation even more, $15 in 2014, and then $20 in 2015. So let's calculate nominal GDP. So over here, first, nominal GDP. And we use current dollars. We'll do it just like we did before. We'll multiply 1,000 by 9. And nominal GDP in 2012 was 9,000, 2013, 15,000, 14 is 20,250, and in 2015, 40,000. But that nominal GDP doesn't really tell us very much because there's some inflation going on. We got to take out the effects of inflation. So what we really want here is real GDP. And the way this is done is first we find a base year. And we're going to set 2013 to be the base year. So this is going to be the base year. And that's arbitrary. I could choose any year I want to as the base year here. And what we're going to do is use the prices in the base year, which is $10, and use that as the prices for every other year. So in 2012, instead of multiplying 1,000 pizzas by $9, we're going to multiply it by $10. This is what I mean by constant prices. So the real GDP then for 2012 would be 10,000 here. The next year, it'll be 15,000, 1,500 times 10. And the next year, it's 13,500. And the following year is 20,000. Now notice in that base year, the nominal price and the real price are the same, 15,000. So whatever we pick as the base year, that's what's going to happen. Now, you might be wondering, well, this GDP there in that blue column is going to make a difference, whatever year we pick as a base year. And that's absolutely right. But we don't really care about these numbers very much, the real GDP. All we want is the change in the GDP. We don't even really care all that much. There's some reasons to care about nominal GDP, but the actual numbers are important. The whole point of this is really to get the change in real GDP. So the way we do this is the growth rate of GDP is we calculate the GDP in one time period, we'll call it year two, subtract off the GDP in the previous time period, we'll call it year one, and divide by the GDP in that previous time, call that year one. And this is the actual way that they do it. We want to know the growth rate. So the growth rate, let's have a few examples here. The growth rate of nominal GDP, so nominal GDP growth rate, we'll take a year, we'll say 2012 to 2013, that's going to be 15,000 minus 9,000 divided by 9,000. So 15,000 divided minus 9,000 divided by 9,000, I get 6,000 over 9,000, or 6 over 9, which is 0.667, which is 66.7%. So nominal GDP grew here at 66.7%. Now let's calculate the growth rate of real GDP. So have the growth rate of real GDP, 2012 to 2013, is going to be 15,000 minus 10,000 divided by 10,000. So we'll have 15,000 minus 10,000 divided by 10,000, which is 5,000 over 10,000, which is 0.5. which is 50%. So we get 50% here. This is the number we really want to know, because that should match the growth rate of pizzas. So if we looked at the growth rate of pizzas, I'll do this in red, the growth rate of pizzas, or 2012 to 2013, that would be 1,500 minus 1,000 divided by 1,000, which would be 0.5 or 50%. So our right-hand column here in blue matches what the growth rate of pizzas are. And if I picked a different year for the base year, it wouldn't matter. We'd still get the same growth rates here. It wouldn't matter what the base year is in this example, because there's only one good here. However, if there's many goods in the economy, like there is, then it actually will be different. And I'll say something about that a little bit later, that yeah, it does cause a problem here, which year you pick as the base year.